This morning I took a little color from some purple sages and also some rosemary, little blossoms. I think it's an appropriate color.
I guess we're supposed to turn off our shelves.
I forgot to say that, of course. I'll have to do it when
I'll look at
Jesus
calling later on.
I'll come up
there. First of all, I'd like to give thanks.
That's good work.
My first prayer is always gratitude. Gratitude for just being alive, for my mom and dad who brought me here. For all the ancestors behind me who made it possible. So we get connection all the way back to when we first came to the earth, took form. The whales know this. They keep track. They keep the record of all of our things. So thank you from the beginning, when we were consciousness in the stars, when we came from the stars and took form here. And in the water, the Shumish people believe they take the form of dolphins and whales. First, incarnation, if you will, of our consciousness. Maybe. And all people come from different places. They're influenced by different stars. Well, I think the zodiac sometimes is appropriate, but not complete. It's not just the movement, but where we actually have our consciousness. So all these things we can teach children now. We got to tell them the truth. You know? It's not just, you know, the evolution. We've been helped along the way. We've been helped from the spiritual forces, the divine forces. So I'm grateful for this day, and especially on the spring equinox, celebrating new life, new beginnings. We're doing that right now. We're beginning this new relationship with each other to help the people with technologies and with understandings and connections to beings in different dimensions. All of this wonderful new way of looking at things. Thank you so much. And today I'm asking for a little help. Help me to be mindful. Be mindful as I walk. That I'm asking for this place to be blessed. Help us to clear, to unblock obstructions, hesitations, doubts, whatever might be holding this place from becoming what it is, a healing place, a spiritual place, a place of teaching, a place of sanctuary. All of those things. Thank you so much for this opportunity. So I'm going to share this gift. Another great. Thank you for all your blessings. We see it every day. Thank you to the sun and the moon for creating these changes in the earth, the rotation, and for the water inside. Thank you so much. If everyone or anyone is moved to share an insight, please do so now, and then send your offering. Please keep falling off.
I would like to share, and I would like to make an offering to the elements, to Mother Earth, to Father Sun, the sky, my playmate the wind, to the stars beyond. Hold us in your presence, dear ones, as we gather here to celebrate the change of the seasons, as we gather here to celebrate a rebirth, a renaissance of ideas, of ingenious inventions, of creative talent, of spirit, so we can transform this planet, our Mother Earth, back to her original glory, and bring here a true renaissance, a rebirth of great minds, of great spirit, and even bigger hearts. Connected heart to heart, all around the world, all 7 billion people, all the creatures, all the animals, the beautiful birds, the trees, which have seen better days, and we hope to restore them to their original glory. The trees, the plants, the shrubs, the grass, the water, which is drying up in some areas, or in most areas. We wish to bring back bountiful waters back to this planet. Not just the salty waters, but also fresh waters, gurgling down the oceans and making them healthier. The fish, the sea life, all life, everything that nourishes will flourish again. With your blessings, dear ancestors and the elements, the stars, the galaxies, and all beings, I invite you today to truly manifest this and ground this, starting from this spot and spreading all over the universe. Thank you. Thank you to each one of my dear family and friends who are gathered here as we ground this vision and manifest it for all. Thank you.